so much for having me. It's not easy being a young LGBTQ person today. While in many ways progress has been made in the past couple decades in the United States, discrimination and bullying and stigma still persist. Then you compound that with all the tragedies taking place around the world and unprecedented awareness of all those tragedies via the internet. And you have so many young people who are suffering with mental health challenges that feel heavier than you might imagine. And sadly, many of them are suffering in silence. I've had a unique window into some of those challenges because before I became the CEO of the Trevor Project, I spent 6 years talking to young people on the Trevor Lifeline as a volunteer counselor. And overwhelmingly, the theme I encountered was a deep desire to live their truths and to be accepted for who they are. And while there are loving and accepting families out there, including my own, you would be alarmed to know how many LGBTQ young people are living right now in fear of rejection, feeling alone, and living without hope. According to our research, 42% of LGBTQ young people in the United States seriously consider suicide every year, including more than half of transgender and nonbinary young people. And while that number is sobering and illustrates the urgent need for resources like ours at the Trevor Project, there are also so many inspiring and uplifting stories of LGBTQ young people who show immense power and resilience in the face of immeasurable adversity. I still take crisis calls to this day, and I can't overstate how moved I am by the strength and the spirit of today's young people. At the Trevor Project, we are focused on providing a critical support system for our community and preventing suicide. In these moments of crisis, speed is critical. We realized that our previous tech platform for Trevor Tech Service was not giving us the speed we needed to reach enough young people in time. We needed to reduce delays in our digital conversations with young people and find a way to prioritize those that are at highest risk. At the same time, given the sensitive nature of our work, we couldn't have speed without reliability. Messages that are lost could have devastating consequences. We learned about Twilio through Twilio.org's Crisis Response and Prevention Initiative that brought together leaders across the crisis response spectrum. And after more exploration, our developers decided that we should test out moving our text line to Twilio. Our team built an automated system that asks a few key questions to folks who text in. Then we run answers to a machine learning model, score the highest risk, and prioritize those with the most urgent needs to the front of the line for our crisis counselors. When we switched our Trevor Tech service to Twilio, the results were remarkable. Given the speed and reliability of the platform, we were able to trim 10 seconds off of each interaction, which resulted in an overall improvement of 10 minutes faster per text conversation coming in. That means that every single person we talk to is getting the help they need faster. The builder-friendly API made it easy for us to integrate our machine learning models for triaging. And given the success of the program, we are actively working on moving other parts of our helplines, including web chat, over to Twilio Flex. Twilio Flex will give us the opportunity to serve more young people at once, build a consistent experience for our volunteers and crisis counselors, and empower our community to support from wherever they are remotely.